Good morning, members. Distinguished chief guest for this regional conference, Sri K. Subramaniam, Executive Director, Union Bank of India. Our beloved President, C.A. Subodh Agarwal, a dynamic leader, dedicated, hardworking, simple and humble is what I could say for our Honorable President. Chairman of the Western India Regional Council, Mr. Mangesh Kinare. My compliments to you, Mangesh Ji, for the excellent way in which you have organized this conference. To the entire team of WRC, I've been working, seeing them working since yesterday. Let's give them a big round of applause. Anil Bhandari, the Vice Chairman, Neil, the Secretary, Preeti Savlas, the Treasurer. Distinguished members of the Council present here, Mr. Adukia, Mr. Nilesh Vikamse, Mr. Praful Chajed, Mr. Tarun Gia, Mr. Nihar Jambusaria, Mr. Jai Charya. And I can just say in one word that all the members, Central Council members for the West of the Western region are doing extremely well. And we are very fortunate to have a dedicated team of Council members who are doing a lot for the cause of the profession. Distinguished past presidents, Sri Arvind Dalal, Sri M.M. Chitale, I had the fortune of working under them. I have been in the Institute for the last 21 years and I have been seeing them working for the welfare of the profession. I am very happy that they are here. Distinguished galaxy of regional council members, all the delegates present here, invitees, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed a great honor and privilege for me to stand before you as the vice president of this august body in this regional conference. It is indeed a long journey for me in the institute the last 21 years, and whenever we have an opportunity to meet the members of the regional conference, it's one big event. And down south, when we conduct a regional conference, we have more than 4,000 chartered accountants coming together at one place. I'm extremely happy to see the kind of dynamism the Western India Regional Council is doing, the kind of activities what they're conducting for the members in this part of the country. And I can only say that Western region is the most happening region in the country. Amongst the five regions, I can very confidently say the Western region is doing extremely well. Friends, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India as an accounting regulator is doing extremely well. The profession continues to be popular. We find that a lot of young generation graduates, non-graduates entering the CA profession, and we are very confident that the way the profession is moving, we'll play a very important role in the growth and development of this country. Having said this, I could also add, stating that today the opportunities for our members are increasing by the day. Considering the fact that India is a happening economy and a lot of new sectors are opening up, we find plenty of opportunities for chartered accountants, whether it's in the manufacturing sector, the ITS sector, the telecom sector, infrastructure sector, opportunities are growing by the day. Opportunities globally is also increasing. Myself and the president had the opportunity of visiting many countries this year. And when we saw that there's a lot of opportunities for our members in the Gulf region, especially the more than 10,000 chartered accountants offering their service in the Gulf region, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Bahrain, Kuwait, Muscat, I think plenty of CAs working there, and the kind of pay packages what they're earning is really outstanding. Australia is another segment where there's a lot of opportunity. More than 2,000 CAs are working in Australia. And recently this year, we opened a chapter at Brisbane. And our Honorable President has been kind enough to dedicate this chapter for the benefit of members in Australia. The third happening place is Singapore. Singapore, we have more than 1,000 chartered accountants. So we would like to ensure that more and more young professionals are able to look at global careers, because the CA brand is now a global brand, and across the world when we go about, the Indian CAs are looked upon with high esteem. Having said this, friends, for the members present here, I would just like to say that yes, we are moving to a specialization mode. Today, industry is looking at chartered accountants with specialized knowledge. Clients are looking at chartered accountants with specialized knowledge. Like in the medical and legal profession, our profession is also getting into a specialization mode. And to facilitate members to acquire new skill sets, we have launched many certification courses which have been a big success. I request the members present here that yes, you should make use of these certification courses and see that how best you can update your knowledge, skill sets on international taxation. It could be on IFRS, it could be on valuation, arbitration. There are about 13 certification courses that are there. The next thing is to embrace new technology. Today we find that computerization is happening everywhere, and we would suggest that yes, you need to embrace new technologies. We will support you and handhold you. And towards this, we are trying to provide technology training for the students in our new technology labs which we are setting up across the country in the months to come. We are playing a regulatory role to perfection, And I would like to say this year, under the chairmanship of our president, the disciplinary committee has been doing well. All the old disciplinary cases that have been filed before the institute before 2007 has been completely cleared. We have traveled across the country, crisscrossed across the country, and I can just say that yes, now the disciplinary cases have been put on the fast track. We have a robust ethical code, a very strong peer review mechanism, and a financial reporting review board that's doing an excellent job on the regulatory fund. For the SMPs, small and medium practitioners, considering the fact that India has many small and medium practitioners, 98% of them are small and medium practitioners, we're doing a lot of initiatives for them which have been a big success: concessional health insurance, concessional medical insurance, concessional professional indemnity insurance, a whole lot of concessional software like accounting, payroll software is all being made available to you, and we would like to continue to work in this direction. We are working with the regulators very closely, with the Ministry of Finance, with the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. We've been conducting thousands of investors awareness programs across the country to demonstrate our commitment to society. IFRS, we have given a revised roadmap. Yes, with the new Companies Act coming in place, we look at a scenario where IFRS would be implemented as early as possible. There's a need for all of you to update on the new financial reporting standards, for which we already have a certification course. On the XBRL front, we are taking a prime move to see that members of our profession are involved in the XBRL filings, and very shortly we'll be launching certification courses for our members so that they are completely updated on the developments taking place on the XBRL front. Our technology initiatives have been a big success. Our e-learning initiatives, our webcasting initiatives. Today, our webcast, we have more than 40,000 viewers across the country. Our e-learning courses have more than 25,000 chartered accountants registered. And we would continue to work in this direction. We'll come out with the knowledge portal. We'll come out with a mobile application to see that members of our institute are constantly using technology for their benefit. On the infrastructure front, our president has been kind enough to see that we set up reading halls across the country. We have an ambitious task of setting up 100 reading halls in the next 15 months. And this year, we have set up almost 30 reading halls, and we would like to continue to work on this direction. Concerns: quality of the young professionals who are passing out, then quality of the professional work, whether it's tax audit, bank branch audit, or company audit, is something which is the council is looking into it. And of course, the Companies Act, which our president would touch upon as an address. I would not like to touch upon the concerns we have on the Companies Act. But only thing I can say, that way forward is exciting. Profession looks very, the developments taking place are very exciting, and I'm sure each one of us have a very important role to play. My clarion call to all the members present here is that each one of you present here should decide how you could participate in the activities of the institute. You could be a peer reviewer, you could be a technical reviewer, you could contribute articles to the journal. You could participate in research projects. You could be a part of the examination system. You could do a lot of things. You just need to come up to your council members, regional or central council members, and tell them where you could contribute. And I'm extremely happy, delighted to be amongst you. I wish all of you happy conferencing. And I'm sure these 2 days would be great fun, meeting all your own old friends, catching up with new developments taking place in the profession. And I'm extremely happy and delighted to be amongst all of you once again. Thank you very much.